Tak dobrý den, zdravím vás tady přímo z šatny zpěvačky Mo a budu se ptát na různé věci od vás a různé věci i od nás. Takže, so Mo, thank you so much for joining us today. First of all, are you looking for, how excited are you to be here at Aerodrome Festival?
I'm very excited. It's been a while since I've been to Czech Republic, so I'm really, really excited to be here. And I mean, I know it's raining a little bit outside, but I actually kind of like when it's raining because then the people that's there at the show, they'll go like all in, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of excited for the whole thing.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. They're your sort of hardcore fans, aren't they? The ones that can really stick it out.
Yeah. Or even just people who's like, you know, up for partying. Even though it's raining, they're like, no, we're here, so we're gonna have fun, you know. So I like that.
Fantastic. And speaking of having fun, you know, you always seem to have so much fun on stage. You know, all of your performances are so energetic and are just great. And I'd like to ask you, do you have any particular, or who's your biggest sort of on-stage inspiration when you sort of go out? Who do you sort of think, oh, do you know what, I'm gonna channel my inner performer before you go on stage?
It's funny, I actually don't really think so much about that. I guess I always just think about that it's so important to just let go and be free and be like, bah, you know, powerful. But I remember as a teenager, I was looking up to Karen O from the Yeah Yeah Yes.
Okay.
You know, because she would go mad on stage. And also Kim Gordon from Sonic Youth, playing the bass and singing and just So I think those are kind of some of the female role models that I've had as performers looking up to, you know.
Fantastic. And from what I understand, you're sort of, especially in your early career, you were really heavily influenced by sort of punk rock and that sort of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
So are we going to see Mo the punk rocker come out at any point in the future?
Well, I mean, people say that when I play live, that's when the punk rocker comes out. So maybe you'll see her when I perform later.
Oh, fantastic. And obviously, you're just kicking off your tour right now. Do you have any, or how do you deal with the traveling aspect? You know, you're obviously away from home for a long time. Do you have any particular sort of rituals or anything that you kind of stick to so that you kind of maintain a sense of home away from home?
Yeah, well, I mean, I feel like I've been touring so much for so long now that it almost feels like home when I'm touring, to be honest. I don't know if that's good or bad, but that's kind of how I feel. I mean, of course, in the beginning of my career when we toured a lot, It took a while to learn how to do it. You know, of course you can't party all the time and you have to drink a lot of water, you need to get your sleep and you know, but again, like now I feel like I've done it for so many years now that I feel kind of comfortable doing it actually, yeah.
Fantastic. And speaking of sort of touring a lot, you've obviously played a lot of festivals, I think Coachella being probably, I mean, the biggest one.
So crazy.
What is it about music festivals that you like so much? What makes them so special?
I love that at festivals, you know, it's like people are on holiday, they're free, they're like off duty, they're just letting go, having fun and like for a couple of days. And I think that's the special thing about festivals is that people are there on vacation, you know, they're like, you know, letting go of the normal life and like coming to this place, you know, a new place. And that's what I love because I feed off that energy, that's so nice.
Fantastic. And obviously you've also worked with a number of very, very famous names in the music industry. Any particular famous collaborations coming up that you can tell us about?
I have an album done now. I don't have the release date yet, but there's going to be a couple of collaborations on that one, but I can't say anything just yet, yeah.
Okay, sure. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Yeah,
it's been lovely talking to you, and best of luck for the show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.